Oh, hi there, folks. It's Jonathan Denwood here, one of the co-presenters on WP Tonic. I'm doing a quick screen video here just to show you how I configure two really popular WordPress security plugins. And I'm going to start off with Sucuri Security, Auditing, Malware, Scanner, and Security Hardening. A little bit of a mouthful, but it's a great plugin. And the other one I'm going to look at is iThemes Security, formerly Better WP Security. And basically, I utilize these two together, and I find it makes it, you get a very effective increase in security protection for your website. So basically, I've installed both these plugins on a test site of mine. I want to point out that you should start off with a malware scan. I've done one, so you click this and basically it takes a couple of minutes and it does a full scan of all your files, your core WordPress files, and it will detect if there's any malware that's been installed. This and it shows the files that might have been compromised, and either you can get Sucuri to help you out, or you can have a if you've got a backup, you could change those files. It's really handy, actually. The next thing, they do a kind of firewall protection. It's a bit like if you ever had a kind of firewall router. But I've heard some that there can be some problems utilizing this. So I don't recommend it, actually. You've got settings. This is if you're managing a site for a client, this is a important little tip. It will find the email address that's registered as the in your main dashboard, but you don't always want to utilize, especially if it's going you're maintaining a site for a client. Because Sucuri can send a lot of email. I'm going to show you how to diminish that. But it can send a lot of quite alarming email, and it could really freak out your client. Because basically, as it's set up in its normal settings, it will literally send an email if the web is a whistling a wind, virtually a whistling a wind around your website. And your client will get a kind of email, there's been 130 attempts to try and enter your website. Well, this will just absolutely freak them out. So basically, you can put your address in here, which I suggest you do that. Right? Alert settings. Now, this is the thing that you really want to set up for yourself, or if you're managing for a client. I switch all this off myself, apart from this one. This is the one that's important. This is telling you that your site's under brute force attack. And I'll go into what that means in a minute. So let's save that. Right? But you really want to do this, even if you're managing the site, because otherwise you are going to get a ton of email from this plugin. And this is the one that you're really interested in, right? I'll have a quick look at this. This tells you, like I say, I've got this site running on my local machine using MAMP. But this gives some information. So we're going to go into hardening, and it's not the kind of hardening you're thinking about, folks. I know your minds. So like I said previously, I don't like activating this. I haven't used the lighters. Utilized it myself personally, but I have heard some bad things. It's caused some problems. Protect your upload directory. I'm still working on this site, but this is a good idea. Actually, I would press this and harden it. I like to make point, you can harden a setting, and if it's causing you some headaches, you can unharden. But as pressing the button again, I will show you this. And you can revert. So things aren't, don't worry to try these settings out. But this is one that I do harden. Restrict content X, this option blocks direct PA. I harden when I'm ready with the site. The site is on the client's live server. I harden this. Restrict include access option blocks. I harden again when it's on, when it's ready to go live and it's on the client server and ready. I harden it. Disguises what version of PHP. Basically, your client's not going to be interested in this. The only people that are going to be interested are the type of people you're going to try and keep out of the site. So I keep that. Security key. You can do this. Check whether your random salt. Blah 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 blah. I don't normally activate this. I do harden here because the only people that really want to read this file are the type of people that you don't want in your site. Default admin account. There's a bit of argument here. Some people say that as long as you've got a really strong password, but if it's a production, I'm using admin at the present moment because I've got this on my local machine and I've got it on my test server. But when I actually put it on the client server, I do change the admin to something different than admin. And I also strengthen the password. So then I do harden. Right. Plugin and theme editor. I don't normally bother with this because fundamentally, if they got this far and they got into utilizing your the editor in the system, I think you're finished anyway. I think it's, you know, that they're in. I do not activate this. This basically the normal suffix of your tables in your database with WP. Some people suggest that you change this. It can cause you a lot of headaches, and I think the kind of headache to benefit ratio don't justify it, but I leave that to your judgment. So these are the settings that I set up in Sucuri. Like I say, I don't utilize that. Go into Harding. Go settings, like I say, is important. Can't talk at it today, can I? And that's around putting your own email rather than this going to your client, because it will freak out your client. They will get onto that phone quicker than in grease lightning. Been there, had that. Now, right to your. Let's go into the other one if we can find it. Right. This is API key. I didn't go into this. Basically, it'll send you a secure API key to this address by clicking here, and there's a place in Sucuri where you can put it, and it's just an XLA plugin. It's fully out yet. Please generate. I haven't done this because it's on a local machine, basically. The main this. We are now in iThemes Security. This is a really powerful plugin, and it does overlap with Sucuri. But I switch off some settings here, and I rely on Sucuri because I found Sucuri in the areas where I set it up for it manages things a little bit better, in my opinion. The main thing what you got to do here straight away is go into settings, right? And remove temporary whitelist is to press this button. When you activate this and it's on your live server, go in here and for God's sake press this button. Because if you don't do this, there's a high chance you're going to be locked out of your own site. And that happened to me once, and it's quite embarrassing. It caused a lot of problems. You can also fix it in here. That up here was the temporary. It lasts for one day, 24 hours. But you click, it's on the top, you click, boom. But then You go down here and you add it, you add your computer IP address to this list. It can cause a little bit of headaches. It's not a problem. If your client is also logging in, it's best to do a video screencast and show them what they've got to do, because otherwise, if they try and log in more than once and they don't add themselves to the white list or press this button at the top and then add themselves, right? When they try and log in for the second time, they won't be able to log in to their own site. And like again, they will get on that phone and they will not be a happy bunnies. So this is quite important, right? Global settings, like I say, the notify email, you can put your own one in here. I really suggest you do this. This will be ticked, untick it. If you don't untick it and save, this plugin is going to send you tons and tons of email. Good email. Your host lockout message, error. This message displays when the host has been... Basically, this is the message where somebody is attempting to log in, and let's say they forgot their password, and after about 5 attempts or something, you will lock them out, and you'll lock them out for a period of time, which is set in this plugin, and this is the message they see if they reach the attempt threshold, and then they're still attempting to log in, and not leaving it for the period that you set. I keep it as error, because if they're bad guys, you don't really want to tell them why they've been locked out, that you're utilising this plugin. User lockout message, you have been locked out, right? I do have this on. It's been locked out, right? Community blockout message, enable blacklist, repeat of... This is a great thing. If your box is checked, the IP address of offending computers will be added to the banned user blacklist after reaching the number lockout list below. And you can remove them from this list, but if a brute force attempt is being aimed at your website, adding them to this list is that they don't even get the attempts to try and get in. I think it's good. Backlist threshold, the number, you can increase this, the number of days. 7 days is a little bit too far. I put it down to 1 day. Lockout period. Here's the whitelist. I do have this on. I like to know who's been locked out, especially if it's a membership site. Right, keep the date locked 14 days, the number of days. Yeah, I'll leave that to what it is. I do not like this. Basically, what this means is if every site has some links, internal, external, that don't work and people are taken to your 404 page, if you enable this, they're logged out. Basically, it's treated as a brute force attempt, and I just don't think that's a good idea. And this will be ticked as it comes out the box, and you really want to untick that. I'm going through it. I do click this, and I don't enable ban leak. This comes from Hacker Repair, and they have a global list of bad guys, people that are involved in brute force attacks. And you, by ticking this is one of the great things of iThemes security plugin. They've grouped together all this data, so everybody that's using Auditing this plugin that clicks this tick box, they share data, and it really does make it hard for the people that are involved in brute attacks. So do tick that. Yep. Yep. More. Yep. I'll leave this. I'm looking for something that I really don't like to show you. You can hide the login area. So they're gonna. You can most places. It's the address / login wp-login.php is the login address. You can hide this, or you can change it. Basically, you can also change it. This will hide it, but you can also alter that. A lot of people like this because I think if you've got a membership site and you've got some way on the front to log in, I think this is a good idea. They're going to use these. Sometimes they utilize Fiverr or Amazon Mechanical Turk. So there's actually real people trying to get into your site, but a lot of the times it's scripts. So scripts don't attempt to go through the front end of your website. It's just an automatic script, and by changing the login page or the address, it makes it a lot harder for them, right? I just thought I'd explain that. On my article, which is on WP-Tonic, we go through why it's a good idea to make your whole site SSL. I don't plan. This is the one that I wanted to talk about. Enable strong password enforcement. I do not. This comes ticked, I think, when it comes out with its normal settings. I untick it. If you keep this ticked, this will force people to. It's a bit like these banking sites where they force you to have lower, higher, so many characters, blah, blah, blah. It's a real pain in the posterior, and especially if you've got a membership site or some site where you want people to join, it could increase the bailout rate. And I really just don't think the benefit you get from this with the pain it causes are in balance. So that's my personal judgment call. So I keep this unticked. Then you've got system tweaks. And a lot of this stuff does what the Sucuri does. This is mind-blowing. I do tick this because... and I do tick that. And that. And that. Same thing, I don't bother. If they've got this that far, it's very similar to the previous plugin. You've had it anyway. But these, general meta tag, this stuff, nobody really wants to know this. The only people that want to know this are the type of people that you don't want inside your website. Right, you all. And this, I don't bother with. So I'm going to save this. And that's it. So I could go a lot further, but I just wanted to give you some quick tips about how I set up these two plugins and how I get them to work so they're not conflicting with one another. And I've played around with all these settings, and this is the kind of setup that I normally do for myself and for a client, and I've found that it provides the maximum security with the least pain to you and your client. So hopefully this has been useful. Please go and have a look at the rest of our WP Tonic website, and if you like this screencast, maybe you can give us a 5-star rating on iTunes. That would be really helpful, folks. So good WordPressing. This is Jonathan Denwood here, wishing you a great WordPress week. Bye.